by years of misrule and ineptitude. That was a correct statement. There were assassinations in the country. Pinto, J.M. Kariuki, Tom Mboya, William Ouko, and etc. Many assassinations. People died in suspicious circumstances. Some left the country in exile. People like Ngugi wa Thiong'o, Mazrui, they left the country. There was rampant corruption in the country. My lord, the constitution, the 20 constitution, was intended to take care of this. The judiciary was not spared. There was no security for judges at all. Some judges, some judicial officers died under suspicious circumstances. These were things that the new constitution was supposed to take care of. And my lord, if you read the constitution very carefully, the way I do, you will find that it does take care of certain things. Certain offices are entrenched. The office of the DPP, the office of the Inspector General, the judiciary, devolution, the preamble, the sovereignty of the people, the leadership code, and etc. My lord, all these things were included in the 2010 constitution to send a message to Kenyans and the whole world, never again shall we go through this kind of life. Never again shall we go through this. The way the Japanese constitution has a provision to the effect that never again shall we have war. The way the Cuban constitution has a provision, never again shall we go to capitalism. We say to the whole world that never again shall Kenya have this kind of life. And my lord, this is repeated in the constitution. If I may refer you to Article 255 of our constitution, dealing with amendments, 255. My lord, if you read 255, 256, and I believe, yes, 255, 256, and 257. It emerges very clearly, my lords, that this constitution is unamendable. This constitution is unamendable. And it is not surprising, my lords, that in one of the books, sorry, my lords, we are not as organized as we should be when you are appearing before the Court of Appeal. My lords, if you go through this book I refer to, Unconstitutional Constitutional Amendments, Unconstitutional and Constitutional Amendments. My lords, if you look at page one of the, this is page 236, my lords. Page 236 to page 274. 236 to page 274. Your name, wrote nice in his thesis for London School of Economics. He has a heading, Explicit Substantive Unamendability of World Constitutions. Explicit Substantive Unamendability of World Constitutions. My lord, he has set out all the countries that have unamendable war constitutions. And Kenya is one of them. Kenya is one of them. My lord, Kenya is one of them. And I'll read to you at page 258. Page 258. He has set out very clearly that Kenya is one of the countries that has an amendable constitution. And he quotes articles 255.
Would you kindly speak to the microphone?
Oh, sorry, my lord. Yeah. Paragraph 255 to article 257. Paragraph 255. I have Article 255 to Article 257 as unamendable. And the reason he gives different procedures for different provisions, different procedures for different provisions, different provisions for different procedures. And indeed, my lords, when you look at these articles, when you are writing the judgment, articles 255, 256, 257, you will find they have different procedures for amendments. When you apply them, it's difficult, impossible to carry out effective application. It is cumbersome. It is onerous. You cannot actually carry out into practical terms these provisions at all. My lords, it's my humble submission that one contribution that this court should make to the able judgment that was delivered by our two by our five judges, that is Justice Ngugi, Justice Odunga, Justice Teresa Matheka, Justice Mwita, and Justice Jairus Ngaah, is for you to strengthen that judgment by making a firm finding or a firm order that the constitution we have now, the 20th Constitution, is unamendable. My lord, that is not wrong. You will be protecting democratic values of the country. To have, at the moment, a constitution that is unamendable, you are protecting democratic values of the country. There are some people in this country who would like to take us to the old days. We must say to them, no, you will not. We have an unamendable constitution. And an unamendable constitution, there is nothing